This video is about HIV tests. What are the HIV tests available if you want to check yourself if you were exposed to infection? Now, there are three types of tests available in the market. The basic one is called HIV antibody. Then, recently introduced another one called combo antibody. Then the golden standard or the gold standard test, which is PCR. PCR actually is the most specific and accurate test for diagnosis of any virus, for any viral or bacterial infection. Let us discuss one by one in short. HIV test is a basic test where it detects or finds out the antibodies that are formed against the HIV virus. After you are exposed to the infection, your body will start to form antibodies that can be detected in the blood after 2 or 3 weeks. After 30 days, almost 30 days, these antibodies can be detected in the blood in almost 95% of the infected persons. But some persons don't show antibodies until they reach about 90 days or more. So if you were exposed to infection and you want to diagnose HIV virus, you have to submit yourself or you have to undergo for HIV antibody test after or within 30 days. If it is negative, you have to repeat it to confirm after 90 days. But of course, if it is positive, you have to go or to undergo another confirmatory test. The most commonly used is called Western blot. Okay, if HIV antibody is 100% or 99% sure after 90 days, why I need to go early as 30 days for testing? Of course, this is important to go early for testing, because if you were diagnosed positive, this is good to start the treatment as early as possible. But if it is negative, you need just to repeat the test again after 90 days from the date of exposure to infection. The second test is another test that can be detected in the blood, that can detect viral infection, HIV infection in the blood earlier than antibodies, where there is an antigen, viral antigen, HIV viral antigen called B protein, called B24, means protein 24. This is an antigen. This is an HIV antigen. A test combined of detecting the HIV antigen, which is B protein, and the antibodies is called combo test. Combo from combination. Combine the two tests together. Of course, this test is now widely applied, and it is better than the HIV test because it detects, besides the antibodies, the antigen itself. So this antigen appears in the blood of the infected person about 16 days, but it appears in all infected persons in about 28 days or 4 weeks, more or less. So when you choose to do combo test and you did it after 28 days and it was negative, this means it is sure or confirmed almost 100%. This was the second type of test, which is combo test. Okay, the third type of test, of course I make it at the last because this is the last option, it is the last expensive, it is the last sophisticated test, and it is not available in every laboratory. It is a PCR test. This PCR detects the genetic material of the virus, which is the DNA of the virus itself. This can be detected after about 6 days from infection, and it's almost present or almost can be detected in all infected persons after 10 to 14 days. Okay, so we repeat again, there are three available tests. The first test is antibody that detects the antibodies to virus, to the HIV virus. These antibodies appear in 95% of patients in 30 days, but to be sure or 100% accurate, you have to repeat it in 90 days. This test is easy, available in each almost each laboratory, and it is the cheapest, and it is also fast. It's also available in a rapid test that you can do it at your home. The second is combo, which can detect the HIV virus as early as 4 weeks. And the last test is the PCR test, which is more expensive, more sophisticated. It takes a longer time. The result can be released in after 2-3 days, depending on the capacity of the laboratory, and it is the most expensive. Now I give you a summary, or in short, the three types of HIV tests available. Please, anyone think that he is exposed to infection, or there is probability that he is exposed to infection, must undergo for testing, for HIV testing. Why? Don't wait for symptoms, because many of infected persons don't show any symptoms, or may show symptoms that look like any other disease, look like common cold, look like any other symptoms that you cannot recognize that it is HIV symptoms. So if you have unprotected sexual intercourse, then you must undergo for HIV testing. Wish you all good luck and good health. Thank you.